Oh, it's so bad. It's so terrible. I'm so whiny. Wait a minute. I'm not 2 years old anymore. Hey everyone, welcome to another terrible day in my ugly world. Today I'm going to be talking about YouTube Red, the new YouTube Red, and the crybaby YouTubers. Right, first of all though, what I'm doing here, we're at the gold farm again, and I've been extending it. Originally we had the 30 portals, which was this row at the front. So far I've added one more row, bringing it up to 60, and I'm about to add another row, which will bring it up to 90 portals. So far adding the next row has pretty much doubled the output. And this one hopefully will triple it. And yeah, okay, so that's what we're going to be doing today. How do I work this out? It's there, right? Alright, I'm going to have to make sure I don't fall when I'm doing this. Alright, so what I was talking about before, YouTube Red, I'll get to that a bit more in the moment. But for now, I'll just talk about, well, YouTubers and how it's really becoming annoying that so many of them are just acting like crybabies, really. They just complain and go on and blah, blah, blah. And it's becoming really annoying having so many of them just complaining about things constantly and just, like, okay, a bit of background. I used to sell real estate, and one of the things we learned there, or we were taught when we're learning to sell, was that you don't throw down, you throw up, which basically just means if you have things to complain about, something's annoying you, something's on your mind, you talk to someone at your level or above. You don't talk to the customers. You don't tell your customers, oh, my life sucks, my life's so bad, blah, blah, blah. And for YouTube, what that would be the viewers. And you guys don't pay mostly. Some of you donate, give to Patreon. Some of you probably do the, what's it called, YouTube Red. But in general, you're not paying, you're not customers, but you are viewers, and you're the ones that are making the money for these YouTubers. So, from my point of view, you don't throw down. If you want to complain to someone who's a friend, family, whatever it is, and just get on with it. So, what am I talking about, the complaining? Well, various things, like one YouTuber I came across recently, he's doing the series on a modern Minecraft, which I was interested in, so I decided to check him out, and every video he is so whiny. He's like, oh, it's so bad, it's this, that. I mean, not about your personal life, but, well, he's talking at one stage about neighbors were being noisy. And to be honest, I could barely hear the neighbors on the recording. I was using the headset and I didn't really hear them, but I mean, fair enough. Okay, the neighbors are noisy. Just mention it. Say, if you guys can hear it, sorry about that, but there's nothing I can do about it. And yes, I do know it's annoying. I've got noisy neighbors. And it can get really annoying because I have no control over it. I can't make them stop making noise. And it's annoying. But the other thing was, he was complaining? That's a new word. He was complaining about in-game sounds, people. Do you know how easy it is to change in-game sounds? Like, he was literally going, oh, it's so noisy, it's so bad, blah, 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 blah. And it's like, what's wrong with him? I mean, doesn't he know how to change the sound? Look, on the console, you go into options, go to settings, audio. There, look, you got sound. And he was on the PC, so he's got more options to control the sound. And he did this, like, I saw at least 3 or 4 different videos he did. I probably would have seen more, except I just gave up on him. And every single one he was complaining about sound. Like, either is his neighbors making too much sound, which, okay, he can't control. Or, like I said, there's three or four videos where he was complaining about the sound in the game. Which, I mean, if he wanted to, he could just change the volume. It wasn't that bothering for us as viewers. And it didn't bother me, and I didn't see any comments to say it was bothering anyone else. But he just kept on complaining, and like that sort of thing drives me away. I don't know how many other viewers it's going to drive away, but seriously, just change the volume, dude. And okay, other thing is the Mojang release snapshots for the PC version, right? Even if you're on console or Pocket Edition, you probably know that. And in the snapshots, they fix things, they change things, and they get rid of bugs. And so many times, I've lost count of how many times people complain, and this isn't just the YouTubers. This is just regular players, people who are just playing at home, posting on the forums, and they complain that Minecraft is now broken because Mojang have fixed a bug. And okay, I can't remember the name of the guy now, but there was a guy. Who was that? I can't remember his name now. But there was a guy a few weeks ago made a video just on this, pointing out all the bugs that are being fixed by Mojang that these people are complaining about. And really, do we want bugs in our games? I know I don't. I mean, games these days, so many of them are released full of bugs. And that really is annoying. And we're at a stage now where they're losing, well, not losing, but I can see a time. Like, when Mojang release updates and whatever that have bugs in it, people complain. But now what's happening is when they fix these bugs, people are complaining even more. It's like, when the bug is found, people are complaining, oh, it's so bad, it's broken the game, blah, blah, blah. But now, dang, if Mojang actually fixed the bug, the complaints are even worse. It's like, the game is completely broken, I'm never playing again, it's terrible, it's wrecked everything, blah, 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 blah. And again, this isn't just the YouTubers, but every user. Well, not every user, but every type of user. You see it on the forums all the time. People are complaining about this and that and how it's broken now. And they never want to play again. And it's like, I just want to tell these people to just grow up. Do we really want a situation where these companies aren't interested in fixing bugs? Because they get more complaints when they do actually fix the bug than when they make the bug? It's like, if they're getting more flack after they fix the bug, what motivation do they have it for fixing it? And yeah, some of these bugs are useful. Like the item elevator in the potion brewing thing I did the other week. The item elevator in that, is it getting dark? And that's been fixed. Well, the bug that's responsible for that has been fixed in one of the latest updates, or the snapshots. And I'm not going to complain about it. It's like, good, they're fixing the bugs. And as far as the item elevator goes, well, so that just means we have to find a different way of doing the same thing. If we want to have an item elevator, just find a different way to do it. And that's what everyone's been doing with Minecraft since day one. You want to do something, you experiment, you explore, and try to find some way to do it. Right? That's it. And if they fix bugs, I think that's a good thing, even when it does break the machines. If it breaks things we're using, fine. find another way. It's like, I watched a video, I think it was just last week, from Etho, and he was starting to build... Oh, that's a bit trippy. He was starting to build a witch farm. And the method that most people have been using for that has now been broken in a later snapshot. So, what does he do? He makes a mention of it. Says that this has been broken now. You can't use that glitch anymore. So let's find a different way to do it. That's it. He didn't complain. He didn't whine. He wasn't acting like a little kid. And seriously, my son is 6 years old and he's already more mature than most of these people. Like, I tell him, well, we can't do it that way anymore because they fixed the bug that let us do it that way. And he's like, okay, is there another way we can do it? That's it. And he's more mature than a lot of these people. So, I mean, come on, people, just grow up a bit. Act like a six-year-old instead of a two-year-old. All right, enough about complaining about those complainers. And yes, if you're wondering, I do notice the irony in complaining about people complaining. But, I mean, some of these things I feel need to be said. Maybe you disagree, and that's okay. Leave a comment if you disagree. And if you disagree with any of the things I've said, by all means, leave a comment. But the next thing I was going to talk about was YouTube Red, which, okay, from a viewer point of view, it just is. That's just something that is there now. If you want to use it, if you want to, well, I wouldn't say do that if you want to support specific YouTubers. If you have a favorite YouTuber you want to support, then there's probably another way to do it. Most of them have Patreon or have donations, ways you can pay them money. For the record, I'm not saying anything about giving me money. This isn't a way for me to ask for money. I haven't got Patreon. I have no way of accepting donations. I could probably set something up, but I'm not interested in that at the moment. Maybe once I got a few thousand subscribers, I might look at it. But for now, I'm just having fun, just babbling about and doing this. It's a good way for me to relax. Yes, I am really relaxed doing this most of the time. But anyway, YouTube Red, I don't know how much I need to explain. It's a subscription service. You pay $9.99 for a month. I think it's $9.99, isn't it? See, I'm not even 100% sure, because everyone just says $10. So we'll just say $10 a month. And it removes the ads from YouTube, so you can watch YouTube, you can watch your favorite creators, anyone, and you don't have to worry about having to watch ads or having ads come up all the time, which, yes, everyone knows they're annoying, but for a lot of people, well, for people making a living from YouTube, it's important, and you probably know I'm not making a living from this. I'm just having fun for now. I mean, I'd love to make a living, but it's probably not going to happen for a long time. But where was I? Okay, one of the dumbest things I've heard said... Ooh, I just realized I'm going to have to take out the roof. Right. For those... If you don't know, there's a... For the first month, there's going to be a trial period. Wait, I only need to do one here, don't I? Okay. And, what was I saying? Oh yeah, there's a trial period where you can try the YouTube Red for free. You don't have to pay anything. You get it for free for a month. So what that means is the creators probably won't be getting any money for that period. Okay, so there's no money being made for the creator for the first month. Oh. just realized I have to close that off. So there's that. But the thing is, the dumbest thing I've heard said about that is that it's like asking people to work for free. Like, one pretty popular YouTuber went on record on Twitter saying that it's the equivalent of asking people to work for free. But here's the thing, it's not, because it will only affect him, or anyone really, if a person subscribes to YouTube Red. If they're not subscribed to YouTube Red, then nothing happens. Like, really, seriously, nothing. People still get the ads, there's still the ad money, whatever donations he's getting, he's obviously still getting that. But in general, it won't make any difference at all to him or his income. And the reason I said that, like, okay, you probably saying, but what about people who subscribe to YouTube Red, right? Well, it's still not going to change anything, because the number of people who are going to subscribe is actually going to be very small. And I dare anyone to prove there's going to be a significant number. Okay, look at the facts. It is only available in the US. So you have to ask the creator two questions. Or if you are a creator, ask yourself two questions. One, how many... I need to get rid of that. How many of your views are actually from the US? Because if they're not from the US, it's not going to affect anything, because if people are not in the US, they can't even subscribe to it yet. So none of your viewers from other countries are going to be able to subscribe to YouTube Red yet. So the only people who can subscribe and get the free month will be those in the US. So the first question is, how many subscribers are in the US? And secondly, how many of those, well, not subscribers, but viewers. It's all overall views, not just subscribers, but subscribers and viewers. How many of them are actually in the US? And how many of them will actually subscribe to YouTube Red? Because I've seen some figures, and most of them, like this from YouTube and from other creators, and they've done tests, and they've got a response that between 5% and 10% are interested in YouTube Red. Okay, it's only between 5% and 10% that are even interested. And out of those, it's probably only going to be a very small number who actually subscribe to it. Why? Because even when people are interested in something, I've done polls before, where I've been asked if I'm interested in something, and I've said yes, but then when it came time to decide whether or not to actually get it, it's like, maybe there's some other reason. Maybe I didn't have the cash, or maybe it wasn't exactly what I wanted, or what I thought it was going to be, so I end up not getting it. So when they talk about between 5 and 10% being interested in it, that doesn't mean you're going to get 5 to 10% who are actually subscribed. And I think the YouTubers need to actually pay attention to these things, because they're not losing out. And YouTube Red should, I'll get to some figures in a moment, but it should bring in more money over time than advertising. Once people are actually paying for it, and this is the big thing too, these people looking at it from a short-term view, it's like 1 month without any income from YouTube Red, but in 1 year period, and let's face it, YouTubers are going to be there. They're not going to quit in the next month or two. All of these YouTubers who are making money from YouTube videos, they're going to be doing this for years. But even if they only do it for one more year, the income from YouTube Red that they lose in this 1 month trial is less than 10% of the income over the next year. Over the next 5 years, it's less than 2%. In 10 years, it's less than 1%. So they're looking at it from the completely wrong view. I mean, over time, it's going to be so insignificant. And if the trial works the way it should, it means over the next 5 to 10 years, they're going to be making more per month than they would if they didn't have YouTube Red. If there is no Red subscription, or they didn't have the 30-day trial period. Okay, so they're not losing out, and they're just being ridiculous. They're not working for free. They're still going to get the money from the ads. They're still going to get money from every other country other than the US. And even from the US, they're still going to be getting at least 90% of what they were. So when you hear people complaining that they're working for free, I think that's just a sob story. They just want people to donate money. I really believe that they can't be that ignorant, that they can't see the big picture. And maybe they are. Maybe they're just a bit uneducated and they can't see the big picture. But I think some of them are definitely just trying to go the old sob story route and saying, hey, donate some money to me because YouTube is screwing me this month. When the figures, the money, or the figures, the information doesn't support that. So don't be fooled. If you do want to support any of those creators, go ahead, ask them if they got Patreon, ask them if they've got donations set up, whatever, and give them the money. Okay, and I'll finish that. The other thing I was mentioning is the numbers. Right, people complain that YouTube Red is going to end up losing their money, but again, I don't believe the figures show that. And for some of the numbers, okay, we have $10 a month is the subscription rate. For the creators will get 55%, which means $5.50, right? Simple, easy numbers there. So the creators will get $5.50 for the from the subscription money. So what they really need to look at then would be, okay, I'm sorry, just trying to line this up. How much money will that actually mean on a regular basis? In an average month, after the trial subscription goes, how much money is that going to mean for the actual creators? So, $5.50 a month will be going to creators. That's after YouTube take their 45%. Right? It may not be exactly $4.50 and $5.50. It'd probably be a bit less. And we really don't know how that's going to work out, whether there's other costs. But it might be a little bit less, but it shouldn't be significantly less. So we have $5.50 put aside for creators. Out of that money, I've seen some creators or YouTubers estimate that a heavy user on this would be doing about 2 hours of viewing a day. Okay, personally, I think that might be a little low. It's 2 hours a day for a heavy user, someone who's subscribing to YouTube Red. I think 2 hours might be a little bit low for an average number. So maybe we should go to something like 3 hours a day. And remember, I'm talking about averages here. So some people will be watching more. Some people would be watching less. I fell down the wrong place there, didn't I? So, but as an average, I think using 3 hours a day is a fair enough number for an average. So over an for average viewer, they're watching 3 hours a day. That's going to be what is that, 30 days, we'll say 30 days in a month, so they're going to be watching around 90 hours. Where's this one? I can't talk and do this at the same time. So they'll be doing 90 hours a month, which means for an hour, that will be around 6 cents goes to the creator. So if we average the YouTube Red viewing to, we got a problem there. How can I fix this? That's a pain. I got problems now. Okay, so as I was saying, I'll fix that when I'm off camera. 6 cents an hour. The current rate with ads, is between $2 and $5 per 1,000 views. So for that, that means each view, the creator is getting between 0.2 and 0.5 cents. So he might be getting 1 cent for every 2 views or 1 cent for every 5 views of his videos. Right? But so that brings us to the problem. We can't directly compare. Like in gaming videos, you're probably averaging around, well, we got 56, around 3 videos per hour. Each video is approximately 20 minutes, right? That's probably an average for gaming videos. Maybe a bit less, maybe a bit more. But if we make it an easy way and just say the average gaming video is 20 minutes, currently they're making between 0.2 and 0.5 cents per video. If we have an average of 90 hours a month, and that brings it down to around 6 cents per hour at 20 minutes per video, that's 2 cents per view. Okay, so we've gone from 0.2 cents to 2 cents, or from 0.5 cents. Okay, the higher end would be 0.5 cents per view, and now it's become 2 cents per view. That's 4 times as much. Right? It's going to be a little bit different if the videos are shorter, and it's going to be different again if it's longer. But even if it's only 5 minutes, that's still 0.5 cents per view. And that's for a heavy user. That's if the averages are 90 hours per month. I mean, how many people do you know that watch 3 hours or more per day every day? Even if you have some days like that, and I've probably had some days where I've gone over 3 hours, but an average over the month, there's no way I've been averaging 3 hours a day. Right? So the YouTubers, these creators, should be getting more for every video. And you also have to take into account who is the target for YouTube Red. Right? Remember, not every video view is monetized. Like for my channel, yes, I've got monetization on, and I'm getting about 10% of the views are monetized, and I'm not getting the high rates, $2 to $5 for every 1,000 views. I'd be lucky to make $1 for 1,000 views, and I'm getting less than 1,000 views a month, so I'm not even making $1 a month. But from these numbers, if people subscribe to YouTube Red and they watch my video, I should, based on these numbers, make more. Because not every video is being monetized. And that's going to be the same for everyone. And the target market for YouTube Red are people who don't like ads. Right? I mean, if you're watching videos and you don't like ads, you've either got ad block on, or you could have, or you'd press the button to skip the video after 5 seconds. And you know what? If you press that button after 5 seconds before the ad ends, the creator doesn't get any money. The YouTuber doesn't get any money from that view because it doesn't count, because you only watch 5 seconds. You have to actually watch the whole video for it to count. So if you think people are making money off those ads when you click skip video or skip ad, no, they're not making anything. No one makes a cent. YouTube aren't paid for that, and the creators aren't paid for that. So this is who YouTube Red is aimed at. The people who don't watch the video, who don't watch the ads, who don't like the ads, and aren't making any money for either YouTube or for the creator. So most of the money, I'm not going to say all, but I'd say at least 50% are going to be people that aren't watching the ads or don't have ads available. They're not making money for YouTube. So at least half of the money that's coming in from YouTube Red is going to be extra money that YouTube and the creators never would have seen anyway. And that's just the fact. I mean, this is who the main target is for this, for YouTube Red. YouTube aren't going to all the hassles of setting up YouTube Red and managing it and working out the details just so that they can make the same amount of money. They want to make more. And they're not getting this money from advertising because either there are no ads for these people, or the people are skipping, or they've got ad block on. So I would say at least 50% of the money they make from YouTube Red will be from people who they're not making any money from currently. Okay, that's the purpose of it. They want to make money from these people. And if they're not watching the ads, then they're not making money. It's just simple logic here. And I'm starting to go around in circles on this, so I am definitely going to stop here before you guys go nuts. If you do have any comments, if you disagree with me, that's fine. Just be respectful. Leave your comment in the comments below, and we can discuss it. I might get back to you if I have a valid point, or I might agree with you. Maybe you've got a point that I didn't think about. Alright, but for now, I'm going to finish up. So I'll see you guys next time. Have a good one. Bye.